I'm Kevin Finney, tight end at University of Richmond, and going into my redshirt senior season. The preseason watch list. It's an honor to be, you know, put in a category like that. You know, those guys are all household names, you could say. So it's definitely an honor. And, you know, I'm really excited. We have, I think today is the day, exactly 50 days until UVA. So that's the main focus right now. But it definitely is an honor, and I'm excited and blessed to, you know, be considered on that list. My goal for every play is to just execute my assignment to the best of my ability, you know, whether that's the run block or, you know, out wide, and, you know, catching the ball. I kind of try to be more of a versatile tight end, a blocker and a receiver, because I was more of a receiver in high school and kind of developed into a tight end since I've been at school here. That's some good coaches that have helped me develop, you know, kind of transition from a receiver into a full tight end, I guess. So it's been a fun journey here with the position change, I guess. Yeah, things outside of football, I play drums a little bit. Haven't really had as much time with that as I'd like, because, you know, it's tough moving a big shed all around. But I also like doing water sports. I like sailing and doing wakeboarding, things like that. I'm kind of an outdoors guy. I like hiking, things like that. I'm kind of a wear whatever is clean kind of guy, you could say. I just kind of throw whatever's on. I do have a large hat collection though. I never go out without a hat, just because my hair gets in my face all the time. I guess you could say I'm a hat guy. No jewelry really though. A lot of protein. I eat a lot of chicken and pasta too. When I was having trouble gaining weight earlier in my career, I was on a 4,000 a day calorie diet with, you know, protein shakes and things like that. And then once the weight started coming, and I got up to 250, where, you know, I kind of needed to be. I didn't really need to, you know, chow as much. But we've got great dining facilities here on campus, so, you know, I'm able to just swipe into the dining hall and have a, you know, huge buffet style meal three times a day. So it's been nice. It's been nice. The university provides, you know, good food to help maintain my weight. I like to stretch a lot. I was told kind of back in the day in high school that the number one most important thing is flexibility, and that's kind of something that I've carried with me to this point. So I like to do a lot of stretching before and after workouts and running. And, you know, get in the cold tub, the ice tub every now and then, just to kind of keep my legs fresh. And that just helps, you know, you feel better about, you know, yourself, I guess. It's a mental thing too, but also, it's good to keep your legs fresh. So, yeah, I'm probably in the ice tub about twice a week, just trying to stay fresh, because it can be tough, and you can get pretty sore after, you know, a week of sprints and weightlifting. It's really tucked away. You know, when you're coming on campus, you're just driving through, you know, a real nice area, nice neighborhood, and then you know, all of a sudden you're on campus and there's the stadium, there's the Robins Center, and the lake and everything. So it's a real pretty campus too. It's nice, you know, having everything in one spot. You can get from, you know, one end of campus to the other in, you know, a 20-minute walk. So it's nice. But the only bad thing is, you know, people come who've never been before. If you're trying to get directions or something, it's pretty tough because it can be confusing at first. Well, I'm a history major, and actually right now during the summer I'm in my my senior seminar course, which is a 35 to 40 page research paper, which is proven to be, you know, quite challenging. It's been a busy summer with that, and I was in Spanish earlier in the first summer term, along with, you know, football workouts and stuff. So it's been a busy summer. I really enjoyed my major though, history. I'm in a great spot here in Richmond just because of the rich Civil War history, which has kind of been my main focus. So I enjoy studying that. My favorite class, I would say, since I've been here was an education course I took. I was initially thinking about minoring in education to maybe teach and coach later on down the road in my life. So I had an education course with a lady named Miss Joyce, and I think that was the most memorable class that I've had since I've been here, just because of her teaching style, and she really had a passion for it, I could tell, and that's something that, you know, if I want to become a teacher eventually, that I also want to, you know, exhibit in my classroom. Well, Corp and I, we were roommates in 2010, and she ended up getting hurt that year in the New Hampshire game, and that kind of ended his season, so he was in need of some roommate help, so you know, it was tough for all of us in the department just trying to help Corbo. You couldn't even get up and down the stairs, really. You know, he had, you know, trouble doing everyday things. So that, I guess that kind of brought us closer, you know, as friends, but, you know, as a tough senior buddy, you know, who's been through so much already with, you know, his injury at SC, and then now to come to Richmond and, you know, I have to deal with the same thing over again. It's tough, you know, watching him go through that, but he's a great guy. He's a great quarterback, and he, you know, always had a smile on his face no matter what. I was in the training room every day getting rehab, so, you know, his positive attitude is something that, you know, rubs off on me and puts you in a good mood, so he's a good guy to be around. But as far as me at the next level, it's something that, you know, in high school I never really thought about. But, you know, once I got to college, and it started becoming more of a possibility, it's something that I've wanted my whole life, and so now it's time to, you know, work harder than ever now that it's close, within reach. So that's pretty much what I'm doing right now, is just staying focused on the upcoming season, and we need to get back to the playoffs. That's the main goal. But, you know, after that, we'll see what happens. let's see. There was a reverse pass that we ran versus James Madison. Let's see. That was the 2010 season. And Justin Rogers, our corner, who's with the Bills now, he came in motion and gets the pitch, and I kind of hold for a sec and then release to the corner, and J-Rod gets the pitch and throws it to me. And all week before, I was joking with Coach Lindenberg, saying, you know, oh, if we run this and I score, you know, you got to put in the tight end reverse pass for me. And so we run it, and I didn't think we were going to run it, but we did, and J-Rod threw a perfect pass right to me, and I ended up stepping out of bounds at the 1 yard line instead of getting in the end zone. So, I was joking with Coach Leiterberg ever since then about how I was 1 yard away from him giving me the chance at the tight end reverse pass. So, I don't think we'll be seeing that ever. But I was just 1 yard away. going against Martin in practice was one of the most difficult things. He's an animal. It's a shame that he had to hurt his foot in camp. But you know, he's been back around this summer a little bit, getting after a couple of workouts with us. So I've actually run into him this summer, and he looks good. I think he's getting healthier. But there's been a lot of good D linemen that I've gone against in practice on our own team that have made me better for competition versus other good DNs and D linemen in NCAA, because there's a lot of them. So yeah, once again, Kevin Finney for the Richmond Spiders, Richard senior tight end, and the Spider Nation and everybody out there. We know what happened last year. We're just using that as a motivator, and we'll be back.